Welcome back to Adobe's Learn from the Pros tutorial series. In the first episode of this series, I showed you how to use shape layers to set up a basic animated map route with some markers. In the second episode, we got everything rigged and set up, ready for animation inside of 3D space. In this video, we're working with lights. Okay, so I've animated the map path and the map markers. Everything's rigged up in 3D space. The camera's in a good position. However, everything's looking pretty flat still, so I want to start to add some depth to the scene. So I'm going to go over to my path controller, and I'm going to start to pull the path away from the map so it looks a little bit more dynamic. So I'm going to pull this up just straight off the map like this. Now, there's a problem right away, and it looks like you can't really tell that I moved it at all. And that's because there's no lighting, there's no shadows, there's no fall off. So by adding lighting and shadows, we're going to be able to increase the quality of the visuals here and show the depth. So to do that, I'm going to right-click in my timeline here, and I'm going to go to New Light. Now, there are four different types of lights, and they can get pretty complex pretty quickly. So one way I like to work is just keep things simple and only use as few lights as possible. And here, we're only going to be using two lights. So I'm going to grab a spotlight, and I'll be using a spotlight to not only add some shadows here from this path on the map, but also to give the map a little bit of like a vignette look. I want to make sure that I go down here and click on the cast shadows checkbox here. And don't worry too much about these parameters because you can always go back, simply double click on the light and change any of these parameters later on. I'm going to click OK and now my light is added and you can see now it's suddenly dark. To get a better view of what's going on, I'm going to switch my view to top view. Now you can see what's going on here. We have the cone of my spotlight. You can see the wireframe of the light here. And I have this spotlight layer here in the timeline. Now, a great way to work with lights is in the comp panel. Make sure you don't have this selected. So deselect it and then grab it here, and then you can kind of freeform move it without having to mess with the widget too much. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna move this light so that it's directly over top of the map here. It's nowhere near how I want it to look here. So I'm gonna switch this to two views. Let's do the right one as a top view. And this left side here, we're gonna do it as a left view. I'm gonna grab the light and I'm gonna start to pull it directly off of the map like that. And again, get rid of that gizmo by deselecting and then grab it again for a freeform look. And we'll pull it to about somewhere right about here. And then I'll come over to this left angle and I'm just going to offset this light ever so slightly this way. Now when I'm animating the camera flying in, I kind of would like it to fly in from a bit of darkness, and I want to see this fall off here from this light. And as I said before, if I want to make any changes, I can simply double click on the spotlight layer, and now I can come in here and I can play with the cone angle. And as long as I have this preview selected, any changes I make here are going to automatically show up. I can change the intensity, so maybe we can bump up the intensity over 100. And I'm going to click OK, and I'm going to go back to one view, and I'm going to switch the view to active camera to now see what I've got going on. Now we can definitely see the fall off here, but there's a problem. I still don't see the shadows from my path and from my map markers. When you're working with lights in After Effects, you actually have to go into the layer and make sure that it is accepting shadows. Each layer has its own settings and parameters when it comes to how it deals with lights. And you can see that by double-clicking on the light right here. It says, note, shadows are only cast from layers with cast shadows enabled. And then you even have to have a parameter called accept shadows enabled, which I would have to have my map accepting shadows, and then I would have to have my path and my markers casting shadows. So you find those parameters down here in a layer, you go to material options, and right here it says cast shadows, it's currently set to off. So I'm gonna turn that on. You also have accept shadows, accept lights, and then there's a handful of other options here, which I'm not gonna worry too much about. So to quickly change all of these, I'm gonna grab all these layers, and I'm gonna type in the keyword cast, so that it just brings up cast shadows. And then with all of these layers selected, I'll toggle one on and it should toggle all of them on. And now you can see we have shadows. They're looking pretty terrible. They're much too dark. So I need to go back into my light here and I'm gonna go over to shadow diffusion and we're gonna crank that way up. And I'll make the shadow darkness like 75. Okay, now these shadows look good, and it turns out that our map layer must have automatically by default had accept shadows set to on. Now it's still looking pretty dark, so I'm gonna add another light. I'm gonna right click, new light, and we're just gonna add an ambient light. This is just gonna wash a bunch of light in here, so I'm just gonna go ahead with the default here. All right, it's way, way, way too bright. I'm gonna double click this, and we're gonna bring this down from like 115 down to like 35. Okay, now we've got something here. I can see a little bit of a fall off here. We're coming out of darkness into the bright spot here. All right, it's starting to look really cool with the lighting. Stick around because in the next episode, we're actually gonna be animating this scene and one of the most fun parts of the process, adding some depth of field.